fiber optic sources uncoupling.
In this module, I'll be discussing about optical sources, direct and indirect bandgap materials, LED structure, quantum efficiency of LED.
What is an optic source? Optic source is the heart of fiber optic communication system. It is a hybrid device which converts electrical signals into optical signals and launches these optical signals into an optical fiber for data transmission. Examples are LED, in that the edge emitter LED, surface emitter LED, and the laser diodes. Direct bandgap material. In direct bandgap material, the electrons and holes have the same momentum vector value. So, the electron hole recombination takes place directly. And moreover, in this type, the quantum efficiency is high and the recombination charge carrier lifetime is less. Examples of direct bandgap materials are gallium aluminium arsenide and indium gallium arsenide phosphide. Look at the diagram. This is the conduction band and this is the valence band. Here, the electron hole recombination takes place directly. The electrons and holes have the same momentum vector value here. As a result of this electron hole recombination, a photon energy h mu is released. As I have explained to you just before, the quantum efficiency in this case is high and the recombination charge carrier lifetime is less. Indirect bandgap material. Here, the energy level occurs at different values of momentum and the electron transition will not take place directly from the conduction band to the valence band. Examples of this type are silicon and germanium. The quantum efficiency in this case will be less and the recombination charge carrier lifetime will be high. Look at the diagram here. This is conduction band and this is valence band. The momentum vector is not same as in the case of direct bandgap material. That is, the momentum vector is different for electrons and holes here. So if the minimum conduction band energy level at momentum vector K1 and maximum energy level of valence band occur at momentum vector K2, then the electron transition will not take place directly from this conduction band here to the valence band. Hence, a third particle called this phonon energy. Phonon means crystal lattice vibration. The third particle is definitely needed to conserve the momentum and electron hole recombination takes place indirectly. That is why it is called as indirect bandgap material. As I have told before, in this type the recombination charge carrier lifetime will be large but the quantum efficiency will be very less.
Light emitting diode. A light emitting diode LED is a p-n junction diode that emits light when it is activated. When a suitable voltage is applied to the leads, the electrons recombine with holes and release energy in the form of photons. These photons are light rays. A LED must have a high radiance output, a fast emission response time, and a high quantum efficiency. It is used for multimode systems with 100 to 200 megabit per second rates. And it has got a broad spectral width and a wide output pattern. The two commonly used types of LED are edge emitter LEDs and surface emitter LEDs. Now let's see the structure of LED. LED uses double hetero structure. A double hetero structure means, that is, if a junction is formed between two alloys with different energy band gap, then the type of structure or the type of junction is called as heterojunction. Since this LED uses two different alloys with two different energy band gap, it is called as double hetero structure. The advantage of this type of double hetero structure is that high quantum efficiency and large brightness is achieved. And to achieve carrier confinement, the energy band gap of active layer should be less than that of the adjacent layer or the confinement layers. And to achieve optical confinement, the refractive index of active layer should be greater than that of the confinement layer. And by achieving both these confinements, that is carrier and optical, together called as dual confinement, the high brightness and high quantum efficiency can be achieved. Now let's see the double heterojunction structure. Look at the diagram here. The LED uses double heterojunction structure. The center layer, this is the center layer. The center layer is called as the active layer, which is typically around 0.3 micrometer thickness. This is indicated here. This is the central active layer with 0.3 micrometer thickness. And these are the adjacent layers. This is one adjacent layer and this is another adjacent layer. One side of adjacent layer is of N-type ternary gallium aluminium arsenide alloy, which contains excess electrons, and the other type is P-type gallium aluminium arsenide alloy, which contains excess of holes. When this structure is forward biased, excess holes and excess electrons from these two adjacent layers get injected into the central active layer, in which the electron hole recombination takes place. When an electron hole recombination takes place, a photon energy H mu, as shown here, is released. Thus, this central layer active layer is also called as recombination region. The energy band gap of active layer is maintained to be lesser than that of the adjacent layers, since the injected carriers are confined in the active layers and electron hole recombination takes place only in this central active layer. This is called as carrier confinement. Since the refractive index of active layer, you can see the refractive index shown here. The refractive index of the central active region is higher when compared to the refractive index of these two adjacent layers. So, since the refractive index of the central active layer is greater than that of the adjacent layers, the light or the photon is confined only in the active layer. And the photons never enter into adjacent layers. Adjacent layers here means the core carrying layers inside the fiber. This is called as optical confinement. So both the carrier and the optical confinement together are called as dual confinement, that should be achieved for better brightness or radiance and high quantum efficiency. Surface emitting LEDs. This is one of the types of LED called as SLED. This also uses double hetero structure. A circular well, you can see a circular well structure. This is a circular well. A circular well is etched through the substrate of the device, and a fiber is placed inside the etched well, and then it is cemented in order to accept the emitted light in the active region. And this diameter is about 50 micrometer and thickness is about 2.5 micrometer. The arrangement is like that. The plane of active region is oriented perpendicular to the axis of fiber. and the emission pattern is isotropic with a 120 degree half power beamwidth. The isotropic pattern from this type of LED is called as Lambertian pattern. Why it is called as Lambertian pattern? Because when viewed from any direction, LED is equally bright, but the power diminishes as cos theta, where cos theta is the angle between the viewing direction and the normal to the surface of LED. Next is edge emitting LED. Edge emitting LED consists of active layer and two guiding layers. The primary active region is a narrow strip. These are the guiding layers and a central active layer. The active layer is a narrow strip that lies beneath the semiconductor substrate. This is the substrate. Semiconductor is cut and polished, so emission strip region runs between front and back. Rear face of semiconductor is polished, so it is highly reflective, while front face is coated with anti-reflective. That is, light will reflect from rear face and emit through front face. Active regions are usually 100 to 150 micrometer long, and the strips are 50 to 70 micrometer wide, which are designed to match typical core fibers of 50 to 100 micrometers. It emits light at a narrower angle, which allows for both better coupling and efficiency than SLEDs. Coming to quantum efficiency and LED power, the internal quantum efficiency is the fraction of the electron hole pairs that recombine radiatively, or it is a ratio of radiative recombination rate to total recombination rate. Now let me tell you what you mean by radiative recombination and non-radiative recombination. If a photon energy is released when electron hole recombination takes place, it is called as radiative recombination. The number of radiative recombination process per second is called radiative recombination rate. Here in this expression, R is the radiative recombination rate. If the photon energy is not released or radiated during electron hole recombination, then it is called as non-radiative recombination process. The number of non-radiative recombination process per second is called as non-radiative recombination rate. Here in this expression, R is a non-radiative recombination rate. The radiative recombination lifetime is given by tau R is equal to N divided by R. The internal quantum efficiency, as I have just now explained, is defined as the ratio of the radiative recombination rate RR to the total recombination rate, that is the sum of RR plus RNR. Now, combining the above equations, we have the expression for internal quantum efficiency to be simplified as tau R by tau R plus tau NR. Now, the bulk recombination lifetime 1 by tau is equal to 1 by tau R plus 1 by tau NR. After simplification and substituting in the previous equation, we get the expression for internal quantum efficiency eta N is equal to tau by tau R. The total recombination rate, that is the summation of RR plus RNR, is equal to I by E, where I is electron, E is electron charge. So thus we get eta IND, that is internal quantum efficiency, is equal to RR by RR plus RNR. After simplification, it comes around eta IND is equal to RR by I plus C by substituting from the previous slide. So R, from this RR is equal to eta int into I by E, where I is a drive current and E is the charge of an electron. Internally generated power given by P suffix int, that is internal power, is equal to eta int, that is internal quantum efficiency, into I by E into H V. And we all know the relationship between nu and the velocity of light, that is mu is equal to C by lambda. So P int is equal to eta int into I by E H C by lambda. External quantum efficiency. External quantum efficiency is used to find the power emitted out of the optical source. It is defined as the ratio of photons emitted from the LED to the number of photons generated internally. It is given by the expression eta ext, that is efficiency, external quantum efficiency is equal to 1 by n into n plus n the whole square. Now this graph shows the frequency response of an optical source. An optical source exhibits relationship between light, power and current, that is shown here as the frequency response. From the graph it is noted that this is the electrical bandwidth and this is optical bandwidth. That is, the optical bandwidth is the ratio of optical output power to the optical input power. It is expressed as optical bandwidth is equal to 10 log P of nu by P of 0, which is nothing but equivalent to 10 log I of nu by I of 0. This is the electrical 3 dB point, that is 0.707, and optical 3 dB point is 0.5, that is if the current ratio is I out by I in, the current ratio is 0.5. That means the electrical 3 dB point occurs at a frequency point where the electrical power P of nu is equal to P of 0 by 2, and that happens exactly at this point here. And the optical 3 dB point occurs exactly at the current ratio when it falls to 0.5. These are the references I refer for this module, and these are the ebooks. Thank you. Have a good day.